Hello guys, in this video what I will try to do is I will try to enter the data in all the text box like email, password, first name, surname, mobile number, new password, right? So we will try to enter data in all the text box and we will see that whether we are able to enter the data in all the text box or not, right? For that again we will create one class called example two, and then again what we need to do is we need to create one text class here. So we'll write one text class public void inter text, and this we need to make this guy as a testng. So click on testorg.testng, right? So you have testng annotations here. And then what we will do is we need to set the path of Chrome driver. So we will write system.set property, and here we will write web driver dot Chrome dot driver, right? And the value, so what is the value for Chrome driver? You go to the driver folders, since it is a Mac, so do a right click, go to the properties and take the locations from here. You guys can also try same thing in your system, put a path here. So if you have a Windows system, same thing will work, only the difference is going to be for Windows user. It will be the same thing, only the difference is going to be .exe. There will be a exe for the window, right? Comment this. So once we have that, what we need to do is we will write here. Let me maximize this. We will write driver dot, and okay, so first what we need to do, we cannot write driver here directly. First we need to create the instance of web driver. Okay, so I just created the instance of web driver, and then okay, so when you write here web driver, you need to import the web driver. We need to import the web driver in this project. So whenever you write the web driver, what you need to do is just place mouse over here and import the import the web driver in your project. So for that, just let me put one space here. Then what we will do now is we'll just place mouse over here and we'll try to import. So just place mouse over here, and okay, so web driver option is not coming here. Okay, so it is saying me change to web driver. Yeah, D should be capital, so click on that. D should not be small in case of web driver, D should be always capital. So you can see that this driver got installed. Okay, and then what we will do here is we will write driver is equal to new Chrome driver, CHRO, and then do control space bar. Now click on the Chrome driver. So Chrome driver will actually get added in your Chrome driver object will get added. After that we have to do driver dot get. Driver dot get we have to try now, because we need to get the URL of Facebook. So we will get the URL of the Facebook from this example one. Come to example two and we'll write here in double quote. After that, we will try to enter the data in all the text box. So we'll go one by one and we'll write driver dot find element by dot xpath. Xpath in double quote we will write the xpath, right? And we are going to write dot send keys, and the send keys we are going to send the data in the double quote, right? Now we'll copy paste 5-6 times because everything we are going to identify through xpath. Going forward we will see other locators also, but here we will focus on xpath. And now what we will do is we'll go to the Facebook site. You do right click, go to the inspect, and we'll get the xpath one by one. So just click on this icon, you can see that, right? So always go and click on this icon and just hover here and get the xpath from here. So right click and then you can go for copy xpath, come to the Eclipse and paste it here. Just instead of double quote, write this as a single quote, and send keys you just write test@gmail.com. similarly we will write for password also. Just hover here, password, do a right click, copy, copy xpath, go here, paste that. Then we need for first name, surname, paste it here, again copy, copy xpath, come in the Eclipse, paste it here. See, that is the challenge here. When you always generate xpath through this tool, this is the problem we'll get. See here, you are getting that u_0_j id, right? So this kind of id you should not use. Whenever you are writing xpath, this kind of xpath you should not write. Okay, so what you can go is you can try for this one, name is equal to first name, you can try, right? You can just try for name is equal to first name. So you copy the first name and you can just try for name is equal to first name. Instead of id, you can try name is equal to first name. So whenever you are using the tool to write the xpath, sometimes be careful. All the xpath which you are getting from here, it will not work. Then go to the surname. Here also, just click on that. Copy. Copy xpath. I think same thing will happen here also. Yeah, it will take the id to the preference, which is not right. So here we can also get the name is equal to last name. And we can go for mobile number. So just click on this. Click on this and then right click. Go for copy. Copy xpath. And paste here. So again id, it is taking some. This id. So actually if you try to generate xpath from this Chrome tool, and if the HTML has the id, it gives more preference to the id. So here also we can go for the name, okay? Now everywhere remove double quote, put a single quote. Okay, in send keys you just write password, here first name you just write first name, you write here last name, and you registration email you can just write something test56@gmail.com. okay, so here our intention is to enter data in all the text box and see that whether this is working or not. So let me run this. Run as testng. So it's saying that a starting Chrome driver on 2.38 on the port so and so port, and then Chrome will be launched here. You can see that the Chrome is launched. It will try to navigate to the site. So it is navigating to the site, and then it will enter all the data to the text box one by one. But still it is, you know, trying to download. So every data is getting entered, the first name, last name and mobile. So you can see that all the data got entered. So that's how you can enter the data into text box in Selenium. Right, with this I will close this video.